Hello, my people. Welcome once again to Goshen Heights Tour. For those of you that are joining me for the first time, this is Goshen Heights Tour, and this is where you can learn how to sew very easy, without stress. If you've not watched my former videos, you can go to my YouTube channel. I will put my YouTube channel up so that you can just go to it and get my other videos. And of course, subscribe so that you'll be aware when I post other videos. We just finished a project. I want us to start another project for the Lutalo. The Lutalo pattern, for those of you that are joining for the first time, is a pattern that helps you to make a dress with just two measurements. If you want to know about it, you want to know how it comes, you want to know how the package looks like, please watch my other videos that I explained about it. Once you get to my YouTube channel, you'll see a video on tiny details about the Lutalo. And just watch it. I did a thorough explanation about the Lutalo system. So, let's get to the project for today. I want to make another dress. We're going to start another project. And I leafed through the Lutalo catalog. I went through the catalog looking for what I should sew with my fashion designers. And I came up with a drawing. I want to do something like this. This is what I want to sew. I want to sew a gown that is either sleeveless or has simple sleeves with a jacket to go with it. This is what I want. Or something similar to it. Just a simple gown and a kind of transparent jacket to go with it. I first formed this style before I now leafed through my Lutalo to see if I would see something similar to that to use to create a pattern to use and sew this my style. And voila, I came up with this. The style is not exactly straight, but then this is what I want. I wanted something like this. So if you want to do a straight one instead of doing this, if you go through the Lutalo, you see something to it that will give you a straight gown. But when I saw this, I said, why not? After all, in my last project, I did a straight gown, so why don't I do something a little bit different? This is a little bit overlap. It will still look cute instead of being pure straight. So I came up with this. This is what we are going to be making. But before I go into dressing this pattern, I want to explain some things for you so that in my next video we'll start dressing the pattern. If you can see here, let me bring it closer. This is pattern 150 and 151. But you can see that it has some letters to it. Like the pattern 150 has VV written on it. Pattern 151 has NN written on it. Now, when you get a pattern from Lutalo like this one we are going to start tracing, you need to have what I call the symbols page. You also get it from the catalog. The symbols page. You must hold it so you're able to know what every alphabet written here stands for. So if you look at VV, VV here stands for dress. Let me look for something and put a pointer to it. Look at VV here. It stands for dress. VV. And if you see the NN that we saw, the NN here stands for blouse. The reason you need to know that is that so that you know the amount of yards in centimeters or in inches that you need to be able to make this dress. And if you see it's written down there, for the dress I need 150 by 150 cm. And for the blouse, I need 90 by 140 cm. Now, for those of you that use the inches tape, because I use the centimeter tapes in Germany here, we have centimeter tape. But for Nigerians or some other people, I don't know which other countries, that use inches. When I was in Nigeria, I used to use a tape that comes in inches. But for those that use inches tape, you can do a conversion to be able to know exactly 150 centimeters is how many inches? So divide the 150 by 2.5. Never divide 150 by 2.5. You'll be able to know the number of inches. I think you know that 37 inches makes 1 yard. You'll be able to know the number of yards you need for this slot. I repeat, to be able to know the amount or the volume of material you need to make this slot, just go down, they write it down what you need. Convert it to inches for those of you that use tape that comes in inches. I use it. For me, my tape is in centimeters, so it's okay with me. To know whether to use 2 yards or 1 yard is enough for this time. That's all. Just to give you an idea. So that when you're going to buy a material from it, whatever material you want to use for this, then you know the quantity of material to buy for the dress and the quantity of material to buy for the blouse. That aside, now, I'm going to explain the dress on this video, and in my next video, I'm going to explain blouse. As I'm going to talk about the patterns. The first pattern I'm going to dress will be the pattern for the dress. So as you can see, the pattern is quite easy. As I said, every pattern has its cross at the center there. Every pattern has its cross at the center. And then every pattern has some alphabets. For this, you can see A here. A means front. AD, what does AD here stand for? You go to your... You go to your symbols page and find out what is AD for. A is for front, D is for skirt. So, find out that this place now is front, skirt. That's what it stands for. So when you see AD here, I mean this particular pattern now is for the front part of the skirt. And then if you look at the way they do all these things, you see some shaded areas, you see some dotted areas. Like here, the line here is not straight, as you can see. The line is not straight. And I told you in my former video that when you see a line in the Lutalo pattern that is not straight, it means that you are going to place this part of the pattern on the folded part of your material. The folded part is where you place this dotted side of the pattern. And then you can see your darts. They actually tell you how long your darts should be. 15 centimeters here. It's written there how long your darts should be. Then you come here, you see B. B stands for back. This is the back piece. B stands for the back skirt. The back part of the skirt. So you see here HM. What is HM? We go to our symbols page. HM here stands for center back. That means this part of the skirt is the center. This part of the skirt is the part. Let me bring it up. This part of the skirt is the center part of the skirt. It is this part of the skirt that will join this part of the top part of the pattern. So you find out that you need to know all these things because you have to transfer it directly to your material. First, transfer it to your pattern after we finish tracing it, which we are going to do together, and then we transfer it to our material so that you will not go and join the back skirt to the back dress. It's possible we can make a mistake. So it is very, very important to know what everything stands for. And this here, shaded place here, simply means we're going to do a facing. You know that the star, look at the star once again. It's an overlap. So there must be a facing. There must be a facing door. One part of it overlaps the other part. So there must be a facing done on the skirts. So you see, and here they have given you 3 centimeter length of darts for the skirts here. It's going to be 2 darts here. So everything now, and I'm just explaining so that by the time we are doing our tracing, I will still explain, but not with such depth. So once we are doing our tracing, you understand why I'm putting the alphabets here, and you understand what the alphabets stand for. Once again, I think I've covered everywhere. I've covered everywhere. And then there's a zip here. When you see this kind of thing, here. Look at it here. And it's also here. You see that there is a zip there. It's going to be a zip at the back. Back at the center of the back, it's not at the side, at the center of the back, there's going to be a zip. So I'm done with that. I have explained everything that has to do with the top, with the dress that we're going to be making. I've explained everything. So if you have any questions, you can ask me and I'll answer you as fast and as quick as I am, as I can. So that is it about the dress. In my next video, I'm going to talk about the suit, or let's say the blouse. I'm going to talk about the blouse that has to cover this dress. It's going to be a very beautiful dress. Thank you so much for listening. I don't want to make the video too long. Thank you so much for listening and stay tuned to the next video where I will explain about the little blouse that comes with this dress. Remain blessed for today and have a wonderful time. Till next time on Goshen Heights. I told you in my last video that whenever you want to make any dress from the Nutella, always make sure that you have this. You bring it out. It's in the catalog. You'll see it in the catalog. So always make sure that you have this, the symbols page, because the symbols page tells you what every alphabet written on the pattern page stands for. And you need this to be able to inform yourself and to be able to do a very good cutting. It is not complicated. It's very simple. That is why I'm here, and I take my time to really explain every detail so that when you're using it, you will love using it, it will be easy for you. If you are following me, anybody, as long as you have an interest to sew, you've dabbled into sewing, anybody can use your time. So, with our two measurements, we are going to cut this and we're going to cut this. But first, as I said, I have explained the pattern for the dress in my last video. I'm going to explain this pattern for the blouse. So as you can see, the blouse too, see that it also has similar alphabets A here, which means that this pattern is for the front piece of the blouse. And you see this part too that is shaded. It means that this part of the blouse must have a facing. You see it is shaded where you do your buttons. And this one, this one here, you see the B there? That is the back piece. These alphabets are very important because once you finish tracing your patterns, you have to transfer every alphabet you see on your pattern. And when you place your pattern on your dress, you have to transfer every alphabet on your dress. It's very important so that when you're doing your joining, you will not make a mistake. So that is why it is very, very important. And then for the blouse too, you see, yes, look at this place. Look at this place. This is the collar. I'll show you. That is for this part of the blouse. This place. That's the collar. But you can see that it's different from the others. How do you trace this collar? See where the blouse is. See where the blouse is. The blouse is outside it. Unlike this one, you have the blouse is inside the pattern. This is inside the pattern. This is the hand. This is inside the pattern. Yeah, the collar. The cross is outside. You can see it here. It's outside. So this is where you're going to place your cross, and you're going to use your post measurement. I repeat, you are going to use your post measurement to trace this. When the time comes for us to do it, I'll say it again and you'll better understand and maybe get a better understanding of what I am saying. For the hand, this is where you're going to place the pin to do your tracing. And then, you can see E here. What does E stand for? We go to our symbols page. We look up E. E here stands for sleeves. E stands for sleeves. Here we put on the symbols pages. For every pattern, please, always hold your symbols page. For every pattern, so that you know what is this pattern, what is this pattern. And then, is there anything else? If you see something like this here, this drawing here, it means that even if you have a full figure, you're not as slim as this. This dress will still fit you. That's what it means. It's written there. If you go to the symbols page, especially suitable for full figure. Symbols page. So, is there anything I've left out? I don't think so. VM. VM is written in this place. So let us see what is. There's a VM written here, somewhere here. There's a VM written there. So let's see, what does VM stand for? VM here stands for center front. Whoa. Okay? Center front. And then if you look very closely, if you look very closely at this pattern, you see some smaller alphabets written. Have you seen that? Small alphabets written. Now look at here now. You see an A here. You see an A here. You see? Why is that? Because you're going to do a cut. This straight line means after doing the tracing, you're going to do a cut here. You're going to cut it off. And then do your facing and join it again. And the reason they're showing you is that you know that this is where you're going to join to here. That's why you have an A here. The A here will go to the A here. The B here will go to the B here. This one, there's no cut. So it really doesn't matter. But they still show you. Yeah? So that is it. I think that is all for now. HM here. There is a dotted line, it's not straight, that means you're not cutting here. Here is going to be folded. After doing your pattern, you're going to place this one on the folded part of the cloth. I think I've done all the explanations that I need to do. See here now, there's something like, there's a D written here at the corner. There's a D here. And if you come to the body of the cloth, you also see that there is a D written here. There is a D written here, showing you that part of the collar is going to start from there, where you are fixing it on your cloth. You see why it's very, very important that all the alphabets you write it, it will make the sewing easy for you. You need to start thinking, oh, where is the collar? Which side of the collar am I going to put here? As long as you've written it D, and it's always good to use a water-soluble marker. I use a water-soluble marker to do my markings when I'm doing the cloth. So it's always good to use and write it there. So that when you're fixing your cloth, it's very easy. No thinking too much. You carry it, put it there, sew it, and you get your fitting. So thank you so much for listening. I think we are done with this. I have explained how to do the pattern for the cloth and the pattern for the blouse. In my next video, we are going to start tracing our patterns. We start by tracing the pattern for the cloth, and then we continue with some other videos with tracing the pattern for the blouse. So stay tuned. Of course, it's very important to use your little lock, and as I'm explaining it, you're using it and sewing it, and you see how easy it is to sew for yourself. And then you escape from the wahala of tailor. and pay after pay buy material, now go and pay huge amounts to make interest, something that you can do. Thank you so much, my wonderful fashion designers, for listening to me. Remember to click the subscription button so that when I upload any video, right now. So without wasting much of your time, I'll fold this to make it easy for me to dress. So this is what we are going to dress now. Turn it around. Let me turn the computer so that you're following me. I hope it's very clear. I hope you can see everything. Good. As I said, Lutano, you need just two measurements to sew the dress. The two measurements, you use it to do your cutting of your pattern, and then you place it on your cloth and do your sewing. So we are going to start this our dress by tracing the upper part of the front. As you can see, this is the front, it's written A. I explained to you what A is. It's written here. I explained to you what VM is. So if you don't know, just go back to my last video and look at it. I did an explanation of everything on this pattern. So that when you're transferring all these things on your pattern, you know why and what those things stand for. So first of all, let's trace this one. My two measurements are my bust and my hip measurements, and they have not changed. If you watch my previous video from the last dress we've made, my bust measurement is 98 centimeters. I normally write it down before I start my tracing so that I will not forget. And my hips is 116 centimeters, and we are doing pattern 150. So we'll go straight to work. I said in my previous videos, if you've looked at it, when you're tracing anything from the waist upwards, as we're going to trace this top, we are going to use my bust measurement. And my bust measurement is 98. So we get the special Lutano tape. This is a special Lutano tape. Look for 98 along this place. And I've seen my 98 here. It's right here. And you fix the pin. This pin also comes with the Lutano package. You fix the pin where you see that 98. And then I'll bring this pin and I'll fix it where I see a cross. You see there's a cross here. If you look at it, there's a cross here. Fix it in that cross. And then place it on your pattern paper. And then we're going to use the tape and start tracing all these numbers you're seeing. You start putting dots with these numbers using the tape. So I place it on my pattern, place it on the cross, place it on my pattern. Make it very sure of it. Okay. So it's firm enough. Good. We start tracing. The very first number I'm seeing here. No, first. This is moving. As you can see, the paper is moving and it's not supposed to be so. So I need to fix it down with a sellotape. And a sellotape, this sellotape, it also comes with the Lutano pattern. This thing always takes time. Don't know. To get where the sellotape is. Ah, good. I've gotten it. Very good. So, let's fix our paper so that it will not be shifting while we are doing our tracing. Fix it firmly. Just two places is enough. Because you know you're going to have to remove it and do another tracing. So it's not good to put too many sellotapes so that it will not tear your pattern. Just this two now. It's okay to hold it down. See, it's not moving again. It's alright. So we start our tracing. The very first number I'm tracing here is 22. So I put my tape, look for where 22 is, according to that line, and mark it. Just mark 22 here. The next one here is 19. Mark my 19 right here. Another 19. Mark it again. So you find that the more you use the Luther law, the easier it becomes and the faster you become. I remember when I used to use it, when I started using it earlier, it used to give me so much stress initially. And you find that with time, you find that it's the most simplest thing to use to make a dress. I'd rather do this than to be measuring all the measurements in this world on my body. Because this gives me my exact body figure. My exact body figure. You know? 13. See how simple it is? 11.5. Another 13. And you are done. I think that's the last one. Yeah. That's the last one. We are done with it. Finished. Remove it. Remove it. Remove the pattern. Because you're not going to join all the dots together. Remove your pattern carefully so that it will not get torn. Because you might want to sew the style again another day. Or for some, you might want to sew it for somebody. So be very careful and gentle. Remove the sellotape. Yes. We are done. So the next thing we are going to do now is we are going to use this. The fashion rulers. The acrylic rulers. My ruler looks very old. As I said in my previous video, I used this a lot. So it looks used. It doesn't look old. Let me change my mouth. Now, to trace this, you have to place your pattern in front of you so that you are sure that you are tracing it well. So I'm going to trace, I'm going to join the shoulder to shoulder very fast, you see. That is easy. Straight away I'll join that. Just like it is in the pattern. Then this side, see this side, it is a dotted line as you can see. So you do it exactly as that one too. See a dotted line. And then the neck. We'll join the neck. Try to adjust it so that all the dots. I hope you're seeing what I'm doing. Okay. Try to adjust it so that all the thread dots can come together as much as possible. Okay, I think we're there. Good. Just draw this round. Here to here. notice here and here is a dot, and the dot stops where we have the X, and this was where we had our X. So we'll draw that dot. After the dot, you see that this line from here to here is not straight, it's a little bit curved, just a little bit curved. So we are going to make it curved just as it is, because these are little things that gives you that figure that you want. It's a little bit curved inside. So we leave it like this. Do this. I hope you're seeing what I'm doing. It's curved inside. So I'm using this part of my curve to draw from this last part of the dart to here. Let me leave this a little bit. From here to this dot. There are two dots. This dot to this dot. It's a little bit curved. It's not straight. You look at it very well, it's not straight, so I need to use the inner part of this place to join this. So it is curved inside. As you can see, I'm using the inner curved side to join those two dots. So it comes like this. So and then meaning only these four dots, these two places is another dot. As you can see, it's another dot that is not up to the, it's not up to here. So it's up to the, just under this last point. And this is the last point here. So what you do, just check that last point. And then make a point where your dart is going to stop. And then we draw the dart. The two darts that is here. Draw the two darts. From here to here. And then the last but not the least. We join all the buttons together, and that is a kind of outside curve. It's kind of outside curve, it's not an inner curve. So I use an outer curve. I'm sure you can see it. Using the outer side of the curve to draw the button. Now, if you look here, there is a facing here. There's facing down here. So if I had the facing is about 3 centimeters from the last curve. This is the last point here. So we get our 3 centimeters with our tape. This is our tape. Just get your 3 centimeters from there and mark it here. That is the 3 centimeters. And then it ends to 3 centimeters from this area. You can see 3 centimeters from this point here. 3 centimeters written there. You look at it very well. So we mark another 3 centimeters from here too. We mark it. So we do our facing. Just draw it the way they did it there. So. Wonderful. What is it? Now I'm going to transfer everything here onto my face, onto my pattern. Everything onto my pattern. The way it is, I'll just transfer it. The dart here is 15 cm. Didn't measure it, but that means on your cloth, in case it's not up to 15. I have 13 here, it's supposed to be 15 cm. You see? I didn't measure, it's supposed to stop here. I tell you everything. So that by the time you're sewing, everything will just fit you to perfection. Boom. Everything will fit you. No matter how your figure is, it will fit you. Because the measurement is according to your figure. That is why I like this pattern. Some patterns just come with sizes. They say this pattern is size 12, it's size this. But at times you find out that by the time you use it, either the bust is okay and your hips is not okay. For the luthanol, this is your own pattern, your own body, how your body is. That is how luthanol just help you. You just cut out everything according to your figure. According to your figure. Everything. These alphabets are very important at all these joints because it tells you where to join which material to which particular point to join to which point. It's very helpful. So it's always good to write them down as you see it. Always good to do that. I think we are done with this. Is there anything written here? There's an A there. I think I've written that. Good. We are done with our upper parts of the pattern. Upper front. So, the next I'm going to do now, I don't know why this video is too long. Let me see what the length is. And I use my bust measurement to trace the upper part of the dress. Because I say it and I'll continue to say it, when you're using luthanol, your bust measurement, you use it to trace anything from your shoulder to your waist. And then your hips measurement, you trace anything from your waist down. So now we're going to trace from waist down. So I'm going to use the hip measurement. And my hips measurement is 116 centimeters. To convert the centimeters to inches, divide it by 2.54. Divide your centimeters by 2.54 to get your inches, in case your tape, you're working with inches. So let's get down to business. I'll get my luthanol special tape. I'll look for 116 along this part of the tape. This is my 116. I put it there. That's my 116. And then I come to the cross on the pattern that I want to trace. And I put my pin on that cross. Then I put it on my board to trace it. Now, to make it steady so that it will not be rolling around, just selected two parts of the pattern with the sellotape to the board. Just two parts, not too much, so that when you're removing it, you will not tear it. The sellotape also comes with the luthanol pattern. done with that, we are now ready to start tracing. I want to start from here, 38. I have my marker, so I'm going to start marking. My first number here, I'm starting with is 38. The 38 is right about here. It's round about here. I hope you're seeing me. I brought it up a little bit so that you can see what I'm doing. 45.5 is around there. The next one is 49. And 54. The more you watch this, the more you become more flexible in using this pattern. Then we have 15 all the way here. 15, 19.5. Oh, I said that it was so long. Make sure you align your ruler according to that line. Exactly. Another 15. Another 15. And that is the last. That is the last, I think so. Let me look at it very well. Yes, let me see. This one here is 38. Yes. So that is the last. We finish our tracing. We have finished our tracing. So the next thing is to just join the curves together according to the book. Join your curves together. Join your curves together. So, let me start here. As you can see here, I think I need to remove this. Careful when you remove this so that you will not tear your pattern. You might want to use it again. As you can see here, this dot, you can see it's a little bit curved. This is your side. This is the side of your hips. So it's a little bit curved. So we're going to use this acrylic ruler to be able to join those two cuffs together. There down is straight. You can see from that curve down is straight. So just make it so. That is ready. The next joining is here. This is a curve. You can see. This is a curve. So I'm going to need this. I'm going to use this curve there. I'm going to try and adjust it so that all the dots will enter. Cutting our cuff there, and then the last part of it is straight, is a straight one. You just turn it to that place, it's straight. Stretch again, here to here. Now let's look at here. Now they're showing you that from here to here, there's a facing. There's a facing here from this dot to this dot on the curved part. From this dot to this dot on the curved part, there is a facing up to the end. So what we are going to do now, from this dot, from this one to this one, there's a facing. Just draw a straight line first from that dot to the third dot on the curve. So you can see the third dot on the curve. So that is 1, 2, 3. To this dot. 1, 2, 3. That is our facing for the skirt. Let me join this place. It is place. Then this line that I've just drawn here. That is where we are going to do a kind of top stitch on the skirt. This is the top stitch on the skirt. I'm just doing that line again to remind myself when I'm sewing. This is the top stitch on the skirt. But the facing itself starts from here plus an additional 3 centimeters from the top stitch. There's a 3 centimeters here from the top stitch. So you measure from here, get 3 centimeters from there. Just make 3 centimeters here to here. That's 3 centimeters. And that is where the facing actually is. So what we'll do, we'll just trace it round as it is there, as you can see. See the way the facing runs from here down here, and here is 4 centimeters. That is here at the end of the skirt. At the end of the skirt here, we measure 4 centimeters according to what is in our pattern. Let's measure 4 centimeters here. Let me do another one so that I know how I'm going to join it together. Maybe 3 centimeters. So that I know that this is where my facing is going to stop when I'm doing my cutting. The facing for the lower part of the dress. All I have to do if it is cutting down. All I have to do yet. Are you following me? I hope everything is clear. If you have any questions, just ask. And I'll answer all your questions as soon as I can. As fast as I can. As simple as I can. Here is written VM. You don't know what VM stands for. Just go to the symbol page and find out what it stands for. And you get it there. And that's all. So this is our facing. The whole of this is the facing. This year is when you show a top stitch to hold the facing down, because the dress is an, the set part of the dress looks like an overlap. It's an overlap. Good. Now these three dots. These three dots. 1, 2, 3. Has to do with that. It's a dot on the dress. So we just do it the way it is done. And here is an E. And here is a ST. But again, I think I am done. Just to add this to this and this to this. And then just draw it and knit it. Everything on the pattern, please do not ever forget to transfer. No matter how small it looks, it's very important. Those are those little things is what actually gives you the fitting. That's what gives you the fitting. I think we are finished with the skirt. So this is A, D. And the drill is done. I think I've transferred everything I need to transfer. Everything is okay. Yes. So, thank you so much for listening. Have you followed to work? This is what we are going to trace today. This is what we have traced before. I have a video on that, so you can also go back and look at it, the way I traced this. The way I explained everything about it. Every single detail. The thing about this alarm pattern is that you have to follow every single detail to get that perfect fitting that you want. Today, we are going to do this today. So straight, I fold this, make it easy. And I place it on my board, tracing board. Let me turn the computer so that you see exactly what I am doing. So it's advisable that you have a board. You can sit and do it, you can stand and do it. There are a lot of boards you can buy in the supermarket. A board that you can pin through. So as you can see now, this is what we are tracing. This is the cross on the upper back part of that our dress. And of course, I have my bust measurement, which is 98 centimeters. In my other videos, I've told you that to convert centimeters to inches, you just divide it by 2.54. Divide by 2.54, you will get your bust measurement in inches, because this tape comes in centimeters. That is how I want to let you know. But when you have the retailer system, it is best that you use this tape to measure yourself, because the tape is calibrated in centimeters. So we are going to measure the whole of this, the whole of these numbers written here, using our bust measurement. My bust measurement is 98. So I take up this white part of the tape and I look for 98. Okay, this is 98. I put the pin. Everything comes with a Lutalo pattern. I put the pin there, go to where I'm going to test. I put the pin on the cross here. And then I place it on my drawing board. So we're ready to trace. But before, so that this my paper will not be moving, I will just fasten it with my sellotape that also comes with the Nutella pattern system. That is done, and we are good to go. We start the tracing. We are testing the top. Remember, we are using my bust measurements to pin it down, and we are going to mark with our marker, water soluble marker, that also comes with the Nutella system. We'll start. I start with this 18.5 here, and I mark 18.5 here. The next thing here is 13.5. I place it very well along the line, and I mark 13.5. The next one here is 16.5. It's right here, and I mark 16.5 here. Next year is 18.5. I mark 18.5 here. And then 15. So you find that it's quite easy. Saves you a lot of stress, a lot of measurements, and all that. And the reason I really love Nutella is that it gives you your shape. Unlike some other patterns that come in different sizes, we all know that at times you can be a size 12, you can be a size 18, but you find that when you buy it, your bust might be big and your hips will fit, or your bust will fit and your hips will not fit. So we are back to the last one here, that was 18.5, and we are done. We are done with that top, so remove it. And we are going to transfer everything on this pattern. Everything. We are going to look at the pattern, draw everything as it is, and then transfer everything, including the alphabets, direct on our pattern. That is where our acrylic rulers come in. We want to see and understand how the Nutella package comes. Please, I have a video on that. If you go to my YouTube channel, you get the video on how the Nutella package comes. And I did a thorough explanation of everything in the Nutella pattern system. So you can go back to that video, look at it, so I really understand it. Let's get this done. If you look at here, it is not a straight, it is not a straight line. Look at it very well. It's not a straight line from this point to this point. So I'm going to use a cuff here to join these two points because it is not straight. So I have to join it as a cuff like this so that it will come out as it is there. I join that quickly. Here is a straight curve. All these dots is a straight curve. So I'll join all this as a straight curve. I use this. And just draw a straight curve on all of it. Just join the points one by one. Join this to this. Join this to this. And join this to this. That's finished. This here is a straight curve. So just join this to this. This here You can see it's not a straight line. First is a straight line, and then under it is a dotted line. Under it is a dotted line, and it's written ST. There's what we call the symbols page. From all my previous videos, you see this is what the symbols page looks like. It tells you exactly what everything, every alphabet written on the pattern, what it means. And you need to really look at it, because it will help you in the sewing, what everything means. Like here now, means that there is a facing here. And when you see dotted lines like that, you see that, you know that it's a facing. And they tell you the centimeters to use. You don't have centimeters here. 3 centimeters. If you look at it very well, they tell you it's 3 centimeters. So what we do, we measure our 3 centimeters to know that our facing is going to be 3 centimeters from the edge of the cloth. So measure it 3 centimeters here. And also measure your 3 centimeters here. So we draw our line to mix the 2 dots. So when you are doing your facing, you know that this is your facing, you are cutting your facing for the dress. The next thing is the dart. They didn't give me the exact the dart, but you notice that the dart comes from the bottom here up to the point of the cross. So what I'll do, I'll remove this. Put this aside. Always be very careful when you're removing your pattern so that you do not will not get done. This one doesn't want to come out. You must come out today. I command you. Oh yeah. Okay. Good. So See the way the dart is. See the way the dart is. It starts from the bottom and ends where you have that cross. And this is where I have my cross. I mark it. Now I'm going to draw my dart from the bottom to that place. Draw my dart. Draw the dart again. That is my dart. Then here, HM, the symbols page will tell you what that HM stands for. The HM stands for here, where is HM? Center back. That is right here. HM, center back. It's written here. So the symbols page is always good to be with you so that as you're doing it, you know, you have an understanding of what everything means. And here, there is a zip. You see here, when you see signs like this, when you see something, this kind of design, you know that that place is where the zipper is going to be on the dress. And the zipper is there. I'm going to draw it now. So you know that on this part of the dress, you're going to have the zipper. Zipper is sewed. Mm-hmm. And the dress is sewed downwards. And then the alphabet. This is B, the back part of the dress. That's what it stands for. think I've already written the anything else here. Yeah? There's an A here. Possibly this is where it's going to join with the front part. Because there's a place in the front part, in our front pattern, that is an A too. They are very important because you're going to transfer all this on your cloth. Because at times, by the time you finish all the cutting, so that you make a mistake when you're joining them, you know where you're joining to what. That's why this is so, this pattern is so wonderful for beginners. It makes sewing very easy. You need to crack your head and divide figures. It makes sewing so easy. It shows you what to do. So we have our A here. Is there another alphabet? Yes, we have our D here. What again? Finish. You are finished with this. You are done with this. So the next pattern I'm going to trace now is the lower part of the back of this, our dress. I have to stop this blouse that comes with the dress. I'm going to be tracing this blouse. So we come to the back. This is the blouse. This is the front part of the blouse. This is the back part of the blouse. This is the sleeves. This is the collar. So what we're going to start with in this video, we're going to trace this. So fold it, I normally fold it to make it comfortable. Then remember I said you need only two measurements to be able to cut this dress. The bust and the hip measurements. And my bust measurement is still 98 cm. It hasn't changed. So I'll look for my 98 cm as usual. And I put 98 cm. And then I come to my pattern, the one we are going to trace. This pattern we are tracing, I look for the cross on the pattern. See, there is a cross there on the pattern. And I place this directly at the center of that cross. Directly at the center of the cross. And then I place it on my board. So you have a board that you can, pin to, so that you can begin your tracing without any problems. Pin it through and make sure that it is firm. Good, and then make sure that your pattern too is firm on your board by still taping it. Everything I'm using comes with the little lock system. Everything I'm using, except the board, of course. You have to buy your own board. But every other thing I'm using here, you find it in the little lock system. It's extremely hot here in Germany today. I don't know how it is in your area. Well, when you're watching this video, when you're watching this video. But today, my God, it's hot. I have to force myself to do this video today. Good, we are good to go. My first number here is 37.5. So I look at 37.5 on my tape, it's right here. And I place it along the line where you have the 37.5. 27.5, right, that's right, 27.5. So, I mark my 27.5 right here. Next one is 25. I'm going to try to be fast. Next is 24. And then 23.5. 24 once again. We have 27. Next one is 30. You have to try and follow the line because it's very important. That is where the fitting is. You have to try and align the tape and follow the line that bears that number. So it's 30. This is 26.5. This is 21. You can see that this has not moved. So it's very important that you make sure that everything is well fixed and steady. It should not move. 16. Next one is 14. I can't remember the last time I made a test for myself without using the camera. I just can't remember it. Just cannot remember it. Because this system is so easy even for a beginner. That is the most beautiful thing about it. Even for a beginner. It's so easy. 30.5. Next one here is 18. 18 and then 28. You have another 28 here. Another 18 here. Then 32.5. Well done. 27.5. That is where we started. Good. We are done. Move your tip. Then we trace it. We use our acrylic rulers. Let me do the straight lines first. As you can see from line here. Hope you're seeing me. From here to here is straight. I can always remove it so that I'm showing you what I'm doing. Let me remove it. So that you see it very clearly what I'm doing. There's no confusion. You may be wondering what I'm talking about. See, from here to here, it's a straight line. This is where we are going to join it. And from here to here is also a straight line. Is this straight or is it curved? Okay, it's a little bit curved. So, we'll use this one. It's a little bit curved. So, we'll use this acrylic ruler to join these two lines. And the curve is inside. Okay. Yeah. And that's it. Can use this one so just maneuver the ruler and see how you can use it. From here to here, 30 is ready. Here is not curved. Joining the bottom is not just straight. Join this to this and then this to this. So we just do that quickly. Join this to this and join this to this. Finish. Now here is a dotted line, which means that when you're cutting, when we are doing our cutting, The folded part of the material will be laid on this part of the pattern. So, here. No, this is sorry, I was going to the back. This is what we are doing now. This one. So, there's a cut straight from here. Join it together so that I get that neck very well. The next one, the where I'm going to have the facing, where I'll put this place, where I'll put the bottom hole. As you can see, it comes 1, 2, 3, 4. The fourth dot. That's when you start drawing the facing. Let me show it to you now. Have you seen it? 1, 2, 3. The fourth dot. So you just have to do, just count 1, 2, 3. Four. That is where my fourth dot is. Let me be very sure. Yes. That is where my facing starts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. That's yeah. So I'll draw my facing down. Ends almost at the center. It's not really at the center, almost at the center of the bottom piece. Almost. Not exactly, but almost. Very good. The next thing we need to put on. Okay, from the second dot up. From the second dot, there's a dotted line down. Simply means that this is the part that will overlap the blouse. Now this is going to be cut in two. That's the part that will overlap it. Then your bottom holes will come here. This is where your bottom holes will lie. You draw your bottom, it depends on you, the amount of buttons you want. You can measure it. Let me use the tape. Here I can see 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I'm going to have about 5 buttons for my own. So what I'll do, I'll just measure how many centimeters is this. This is 50 centimeters, so I need 10 centimeters between each button. So I'll just mark 10. I know where I'll be putting my button. Okay. 30, 40. So all I have to do is just draw. This is where I'm going to be doing my buttons to guide me when I'm doing the button rolls. So I know exactly where I put my buttons in my blouse. Hmm? Good.
Fifty.
And then B and here. So let you know which part of the material this is. B and then there is a D here. Let us now join the shoulder. The two dots that makes the shoulder. Just join this to this. And then the armhole, we use this part of it to draw the armhole. Shifting so you see exactly what I am doing. Keep adjusting it so that all the points is aligned with the cup. So all my points is aligned so I can now draw the ammo. Open my ammo, you can see it. The next one is yes, this place. You can see how you draw it up to where the cross is. I've marked where I put my cross. So I'm going to draw that. Start to do for the dart. But we are going to cut off when we are doing the cutting. So you know that when you're doing your cutting, when we are doing the cutting, definitely I'll video it. You know that you're going to cut off this. So that when you join it, to give you the fitting for the blouse. C is here. This thing will show you where to join it to the front part of the blouse. To the back part of the blouse, rather. You can see here, there's also a C on the back part. When we are tracing the back part, you see, showing you this where this goes with this when you're joining it. I think we are done A to show that this is the front part. But again. A, B, A, B. That's here. It's finished. The front pattern is finished. So, let me be sure I've transferred everything. Because my next time I'm going to use this pattern is to put it on my dress. After I've cut it off, of course. After I've cut it off, I'll put it on the dress. So let us be sure now everything has been transferred there. I think so. Yes, so the pattern is finished. The front pattern for this dress is finished. The front pattern is finished. So what we just finished tracing is this front. What we just finished tracing is this front part of the blouse. So in our next video, we'll go ahead and trace the back part. This blouse. I want to thank you so much. for listening. I need to check a bit. As you can see, I placed it on 98. Then place it on the cross that you find on every pattern on Little Life. You find a cross on every pattern. This cross here. I'll place my pin there. Then I put it on my board. Make sure it is firm. And then of course I sellotape it down so it will not be moving when I'm tracing. For those of you that have been following me, by now you should be getting used to using your Lutalo. For those of you that are just tuning in, you can always go and watch the video on how I explain what the Lutalo is all about, how it comes, explain the catalog, everything in the catalog, I explain it. There's a video on it, so once you get to my channel, you'll get the video. And believe me, once you start using the channel, there'll be no going back. So, our tape is firm, we start our tracing. Let me start from the upper part. There are more numbers up than down. I start here. The first number here is 15.5. I mark my 15.5 quickly. 15.5 on the tape. The next line here is 12.5. Quickly, I mark it 12.5. Next one is 14. Quickly. 14. I think that 14 should land up. It's supposed to be there. 14. The next one is 19. Yeah. This is 19. I have to cancel this. 19. Next one is 26.5. Okay. Is here. 28 is here. 28 again. 29.5. 6, but it is a jointed line. That is to let you know that there is going to be no cut when you are cutting your material. That side will be folded. So let's draw that straight line first. Let's do that first. Bottom line is a straight line too. So we just draw a straight line to this dot, to this dot. And a straight line to this dot. From the dot here to the dot here too, it's a straight line. Is it straight? Yeah, it's a straight line. The upper one is a little bit curved, it's a straight line. But the line from this dot to this dot is a little bit curved. If you look at it, let me remove it and show you so that you see it clearly what I'm talking about. That's a very good one, so you look up, you won't see any pattern. This dot. You can see it's not straight, it's a little bit curved. So we're going to use this, our curving ruler. to join that group together. So as this family is disturbing me, I'm going to have to switch it off. Okay, let's join our call. Just the cup of the armhole. The cup of the armhole. Which we're going to use this. Wonderful. Shoulder. You see that there's a small dot here that comes to this point here. And it comes from these two here. From these two dots, you draw a short dot, which is what I want to do now. Very short dot. That is finished. Then the last one is the leg, of course. The leg, the back, which is a little bit curved too. I'll draw it so. And then let us now draw our bat. As I said, the bat starts from where we had our cross. As you can see, it starts from the cross. Join these two dots. Join these two dots, which is what I'm going to draw now. Where the waist is. Always remember to transfer everything on your pattern to the pattern that you've collected. Always transfer everything. The alphabet, there's a C there. This is B. You find that is the back of the gloves. There's an HM here, center side, and then this is the dot. This marker comes with a little letter. So this is the letter, is the dot, which we are going to transfer to our dress when we are placing our pattern on the dress to cut it. Anything else? There's the it's finished. It's completely finished. So you are finished with the bag. So all you have to do is to carry this, cut it off, and place it on your cloth to cut it, which I will also show it, because I have to show you how to make sure that you give your half an inch when you are cutting. Wonderful. We are done with that. So, in my next video, I'm just going to just continue to trace the hand we trace the hand and we trace the color. And we are done with our pattern. Thank you so much for listening. Anything from your waist upwards, use your bust measurement on the tip. You need a lot of it. But if you're tracing anything from the waist downwards, use your hip measurement. Without wasting time, loss gate, that means less move in Dutch. Yes, okay. We are going to test this hand. So, as you can see, I put my pin on 98, which is my bust measurement, 98 cm. I've told you before how to convert cm to inches in case you're using tape that is inches. Because this tape is in centimeters. The reason that you might need to convert is when you're looking to know the number of materials or the yards of materials you might need to use to make this dress. And I've explained it in my previous videos, how you can convert your inches, your centimeters to inches. Okay, we fixed our pin. I will just so they tape it down so that it will not move when we are tracing. Let's tape it down. Because the tape only 2 pieces is okay. I need to tape too much. Just 2 pieces is okay. That's alright. So we go ahead immediately and start tracing for the arm. The first thing here is 19. We mark our 19 on the tape, 19.5, 16. This one is going to be quite easy because there's nothing complicated here. Just trace the numbers, 15. If you follow me, this will be very easy for you. You follow me right from the one when we started tracing this, 15.5. This color becomes quite easy, and quite interesting. 16.5, 17. 16. Done. The cutouts are there. So the next thing is, I want to also place it here. If you notice here, okay, let me finish. I'll explain this in case you're not seeing me. That the cross here for the color is outside the pattern. So at times it happens like that. They show you that this cross here, G, is for the collar. So we bring it, still 98, I have not removed it. Place it on the cross. So right now I'm going to trace for the collar. We go here. The first thing here is 21 and 25. So I'm going to do 2 dots. I'm going to do a dot at 21. And I'm going to do it at 25. For this particular line. The next line is 25.5. So 25.5 and then 22 and then 28 25. That's 1.5. And then the last one is 29.5. Finished. It's finished. We are finished. Remove it. We are finished finally. What I'll do now is just trace the curve of the hand little by little. this convey. You can use your hand and just twist it. It's like the ruler was trying to give me a little bit. So, dot to dot. Here. Here. And that's all. And that's all. This V is very important because it is showing that this is the part that goes to the front part of the dress. It's very important that we have it to write that V. And then E is to show that this is the hand. And then the arrow. And then we draw the line here. For the sleeve. And then a dot to show that there's a little facing at the edge of the hand. Finished. So let us go over here and draw our collar. The collar has a little curve here. Just a little curve. So let me just draw it. Make sure you align the dots. See? So you just draw it from here to there. Yes, that is where you're going to fold the material when you're cutting it. That's going to center, and then it's going to have the facing. We are finished. We have finally reached the last part of the pattern for this dress. I think it's up to 5 videos or so of tracing this pattern. So we've eventually finished. This is the last of it. I'm going to cut off all the patterns. And then in my next video, I'm going to place my pattern on my material and we're going to do the cutting. And after that, this video is finished. I'll do the sewing. I don't video the sewing. Just do the sewing after I finish sewing and I'll come and show you the fitting of the sewing. Thank you so much if you watched the video from beginning till now. I hope that your dress will come out beautifully. And if you have used it, please just show me a photo of your video. Let the dress, you know, upload it with all the time needed to make this dress. This video, I am going to place the patterns on my cloth. And I'm going to show you how to transfer everything to the cloth. And I'm going to show you how, where you're going to cut your pattern. The seam allowance you're going to give. And I'm going to show you how you're going to make it very simple for yourself to sew. So all you need is to stay tuned. And let us move on. What do you need for this stage? What you need is your tape. You can use a normal tape. But I still don't have it. I still use the Vintalo. Special tape because this side of it is a centimeter, so I can use it. So you need a tape, you need a ruler, or you can use the normal measuring scale ruler. I have it, it's not here, but I have it somewhere in my detail of the real mission. You need a water soluble marker. And of course, you need your tenor stroke. And you need your pins. You need your pins. Where did I keep my pins? Aha. You need your pins. So, without wasting much time, let's get straight to business. As you can see, my table is already set. It's already set. This is my material. This is my tailor's chalk. This is my water soluble marker. This is my tape. So what I do now, I place all my patterns. Every pattern you're seeing here is a pattern for the dress. Every pattern you're seeing is a pattern for the main dress. I've already placed it here. As you can see, you need 150 by 150. You need 150 by 150 centimeters. That's about 2 yards of material. So this my material is 2 yards. Folded. The back part facing me. Folded and the back part facing me. So that's the very first thing. You get your material, 2 yards material, fold it together, place it on your board with the back part. Now place your patterns. How do you place your patterns? Remember that this pattern, this is the front part, upper part of the pattern. And right here, you can see that the line here on this pattern. Let me remove it so that you see it very well. You see that the line here on this pattern is not straight. It's dashed. So this part of the pattern, you place it on the folded end of your material. The folded end, as you can see, place it at the edge of the folded end of your material. And I will say that before you cut out your dress with your pattern, transfer everything in your pattern to your dress. Everything. So as you can see here, I'm going to use this to do illustration, because whatever I do here is what I will do for all. I will not video all, so I will just use this particular one and this one perhaps for the illustration of these videos. But whatever I'm doing here is the same thing I'm going to do for this pattern, for this pattern. So what I'm showing you now is that you have your two layers folded together, and every pattern for the dress is already in place. This is the lower part of it, lower front. This is the back front of the pattern. This is the back upper part. This is the front upper part. Now, as you can see here, I've used my tailor stroke to do a drawing and to trace this thing. First, I traced exactly the pattern on my dress. Exactly, just trace exactly what the pattern looks like on the dress. And then, you use your tape and measure 1 cm or 2 cm. I use 2 cm, as you can see. Measure 2 cm all around. 2 cm all around. 2 cm all around it. From the edge to your cloth. Just measure your 2 cm. This 2 cm will serve as your sewing allowance. And when you're cutting this pattern from this dress, you're going to cut from here. You're going to cut from that 2 cm. This is where you're going to cut this pattern out. And then the pattern, the place you have drawn directly on the pattern is where you're going to sew. Like when you're joining this to this skirt, you're going to sew on this line. Just like you're going to sew on the exact line that I will draw around the skirt. I repeat, first trace each pattern according to the way it is, exactly as it is. Trace it with your tailor stroke. And then measure 2 cm, or if you like 1 inch. This is a cm, for those of you using inches, you can use your 1 inch. Measure 1 inch, just mark it all around it, so that after marking it, you now draw all around it. You draw it everywhere, measure your 2 cm, or 1 inches, measure all around it. So, after doing that, the next thing is for you to transfer the dart. So all I have to do there, you just mark where this dart starts here. Mark where it starts here. Lift it up. two dots where the dot ends. So you can see. And then use your ruler and just draw the two ends together to make your dots with your tailor stroke. Just draw it and draw this. So you have your dots. Bring this back. You have your dots in place. Do the same thing for this other dart. As you can see, there are two darts here. This one under the breast and this one from the waist up. So you do the same thing that I just did. Just mark with your tailor stroke. Mark with your tailor stroke. Lift up. Put your finger where the dart ends. Do your marking there. Lift it away. Use your ruler. Then just draw all the markings that you've done. Draw it together to get your so we are done with that. What is remaining now? The point where you have the facing, as you can see here. The point you have the facing, do the same thing, just mark where the facing starts here. And mark where it ends here. Mark where it ends here. And mark the curving here. So all you have to do is just join it, freehand joining. Join all the points together with your tailor stroke. So that you know when you're cutting your facing. When you're cutting the facing you want to use here, you just know how long you're going to cut it. That is it. Now for facing, this is what I'll use to cut my facing. To use it to make the cloth a little bit firmer. For those of you that sew, as I said, this is not a place for me to teach you how to sew. It will show you how easy it is to cut and make clothes with just two measurements. But it's good to just let you know that you need this when you're doing this, to just place it when you cut the facing, you place it here on your dress. So you need to buy that from any store that sells sewing things. It's quite easy to find. Good, we are done with that. We have done our chest, our pattern. We have given it the sewing allowance. I need to pin this down again. So we do need the sewing allowance. We have drawn our darts. So now we're going to transfer all the alphabets. All the alphabets here to our dress. That is when we need our water soluble marker. So you transfer everything because it will help you simply when you're joining the materials together. Where to join to where. But by the time you got all these pieces away, at times it can be a little confusing. Especially with materials that the front and the back almost look alike. When it is big like this, it's easy to differentiate. But sometimes if you're using a material that the front or the back is not so easy to differentiate, this will always help. We use a water soluble marker. Just mark A there. A is written there. VM is written there. VM. C is written here at the edge here. I put my C. And then this A to show that this is the front upper piece. I put my A there. So once I cut this, once I look at the piece, I know what to do with it. Now, I'm going to do the same thing for this. I don't think I need to repeat myself, as I said. I'm doing the same thing for this. As you can see, this one, this is the back part of it. This one really, you can see here, there's going to be a zip. It's going to be a zip. Just like the zip continues here. The zip continues here. Continues here. This is the back part of the lower part of the pattern. So what I'll do here is exactly what I've just finished doing here. So I do not think I need to bore you with that. But in case you didn't understand it, I'll repeat again. For the second one, draw everything with your bias. Draw everything with your tailor's chalk, sorry. Draw everything with your tailor's chalk. Exactly the pattern. Draw it on your dress, at the back part of your dress. Dress it as it is, exactly as it is. And then you use your tape and you measure 2 centimeters away from the edge. Just measure 2 centimeters away. Measure 2 centimeters away from every edge of it. 2 centimeters away. Measure it. Then later you're going to join measurements, trace the pattern again, but 2 centimeters away from the original. But the shape will be exactly the shape of the pattern. Now it is this second drawing, this part, that's where you're going to do the cutting. That's where your cutting is going to be. That's where you're going to cut your dress. That's where you cut your dress. And then when you finish doing that, you now transfer all the darts. At this back one, transfer all the darts, draw the darts so, put your hand here, make your mark, and then use your ruler and join all the marks to get the darts. And then transfer the facing. This has a facing too on the back. All you need to do is to match the two faces. And then use your ruler to draw together. To join the two places together. To show where you're going to do your facing for the back. Use your water syllable marker to transfer the alphabet to your material. A is here. And of course, this is B, showing you that this is the back part of the dress. You're done. I'll do exactly what I've done here with the lower front part and the lower back part of this pattern. And once I'm done, I will now cut off. And I'll carry my material as I've cut it and place it on my lining. And just cut it exactly on my lining for this dress. When it comes to the skirts, when I'm cutting the lining for the skirts, I will cut my lining from here. Because the whole of here is facing for the skirt, as you can see. The whole of here is facing. So I'm going to cut my lining from here. The line is going to be from here to here. It's going to take this shape. That is the lining. It will just take this shape. Because the whole of this place is going to be facing. And this facing, I'm going to use the material for the facing. And I'm going to use the stay for the facing. But this part of it will overlap each other. If you look at the style, it's going to be a little overlap. So this place here will be a stay for that overlap. So that's exactly what I'll do with the skirt. I think we are done with this video. I've explained everything. The process I've used for this two. The same process I'll use for the other skirt side to do the cutting. I want to thank you so much because I must say that we have come to the end of our pattern drafting, pattern cutting. And in my next video, I'm going to wear the dress. I'm going to start sewing. And once I finish, of course, I'll wear the dress see the fitting, so that you know that having written up is very handy. I'm not going to show a video of how I cut this blouse, because it's essentially the same principle, to be like boring you, because I'm going to upload a lot of videos. For this blouse, I'm going to use this lace material, transparent lace, to do the blouse, and I'm going to place it the same way, the same method I used to cut the top. The only difference is that for the blouse, I'm going to use the material that you just saw for this place to be able to do a good button hole. So that's just the difference. That's just the only thing that will be different. For the button hole pattern, for that place, that's what I will do. Because I already have my pattern for that. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you for your patience. If you've watched all the other videos up to these videos, then you're very interested in sewing. And you've reached the best channel that can give you the simplest way to make perfect fitting clothes. Thank you so much, and I pray that you stay tuned for our next project. Remain blessed. Hello. Now, how do I look? Our pattern 150 of our Lutano pattern is finally ready. So you can see, this is the dress that we started some time ago. We traced everything from the pattern. I showed it to you. Welcome to Koshin House, where I teach you how to make beautiful fitting clothes, just like this one, with just two measurements, using just patterns to make clothes. I teach you how to sew clothes with ease, without stress, perfectly fitting clothes. So this is the outcome of this style, as you can see. Now look at this beautiful curve of the dress. I'll get up and look at it. That is it. That is the cuff up there. You can see that. Look at the fitting. This is the blouse. That is the blouse. So look at the fitting. It's so beautiful. And the amazing thing about this is that you can decide to wear it with this, or I can decide to wear it without it. I want to show you the fitting that Lutano pattern gives, even to sleeveless clothes. So look at this, the cloth itself. Just take a look at it. As you can see here, there's nothing to show any part of you. It's very, very, you know, decent. Very decent. But it covers so well. Very decent. So you can even decide to wear this without even wearing the coat. Can you say to just wear this? I'll go for a summer party, especially if the sun is very hot. Can you decide to wear this? And maybe just carry your coat with you. You don't want to wear it, you know? If it is a little bit cold later, you put it on. The point is, it's decent enough and fitting enough for you to be able to wear it like that without any problems. And of course, as usual, for Goshen Heights. I made a bag to go with it. I made a bag to go with this lovely dress. How do you like this bag? How would you like to have a bag that goes very comfortably and beautifully with your dress? If you want the pattern for this bag and you like to make it, please visit my website. You'll see it written on top there, www.digitalizefashiondesign.com. When you get there, you see how you can get the pattern for the bag and even the instructions on how to make the bag. So that when you are finished making your clothes using your internal pattern, you can also make yourself a bag. It must not be exactly, but at least you can make something, you know, similar to this. As long as you have the pattern, it's quite easy to follow. And my instructions are very, very simple to follow. So it will make you stand out. I mean, when somebody comes out and you wear this, carry this bag, definitely people will look and say, where did you get this now? You look so nice. You know? And that's the point. And you start marketing yourself. Business has started. So thank you so much for following me up to this stage. The fact that you've reached this stage simply means that you've got your new channel. You've made yourself this beautiful summer dress. I call it the summer dress. And, of course, you're ready to show people what you can do and market yourself. Thank you so much for staying with me. And I hope you continue to stay, because I'm going to bring out more beautiful things that you can make for yourself. Remain blessed.